Welcome back. Now, there's talk in the U.S. of sending even more weapons to the Ukraine and to Israel. Of course, the military-industrial complex, the merchants of death want that as a profit center, a continuing profit center. But we have the merchants of debt, the banks, who are also wanting to get into the fight, and they got their wish today. We have some EU sanctions that are coming against Russia's biggest banks, including their largest bank. The European Union has imposed sanctions on five Russian banks, including the country's biggest. These financial entities will be banned from raising capital on the EU's capital markets. In other words, they're going to be banned from competing with the Western banks. Now, what we see happening here is a kind of asymmetric warfare. They can keep the Russians out of the very lucrative Western economies, but at the same time, the Russians are working to do an end round of the entire financial system, that is, to take down the American dollar with an alliance with Brazil, as well as India, China, and South America. That's the BRICS. If they can do that, that will be a crippling blow to the Western financial system. Now, there's a news from WikiLeaks. They put out a tweet a couple of days ago speculating as to whether or not Russia was going to renew Snowden's visa. If you remember, it was about a year ago that he was given asylum there. It expired and was up for renewal today, and they said, will they be trading him in for better relations with the West? Well, I don't know, but I tell you what, Putin is no friend of free speech either, because we see in this news from The Guardian that just like those in the West, the Russian government is now cracking down on individual journalists, on bloggers, on social media. They want to control freedom of the press there and free speech every much as the Western governments do. Look at this story from The Guardian. Russia tightens controls on the blogosphere. Bloggers say new law is an attempt to crack down on free expression and criticism of the Russian government. A law that comes into effect on Russia tomorrow will place tighter controls on the blogosphere, one of the few remaining places where people can freely criticize the government. Popularly known as the Law on Bloggers, the legislation requires users of any website whose posts are read by more than 3,000 people each day to publish under their real name and register with the authorities if requested. See, whenever they think anything is dangerous, like free speech or the freedom to keep and bear arms, the right to keep and bear arms, they want you to register those freedoms with you so they'll know who's using these freedoms that they feel threatened by. And they clearly pointed out what is obvious to all of us if you think about it. They say it's about creating a situation where Big Brother is watching you, said one of the media entrepreneurs and a popular blogger. He said, you're part of a list. You are being watched. You're being observed. You're being served notices. You could even serve a criminal sentence if you choose to speak out. That's what the registration is really about. They want these bloggers to know that they're being watched. They want to underscore that in the same way that the Western governments leaked out about a year and a half ago, the fact that they were spying on AP reporters and other reporters. They like to send that out as a bit of intimidation. And so that's some intimidation of free speech in Russia going on there. We may remember it was about a month ago that the German government told the CIA chief to get out of Germany. Well, it's not just the German government, it's our own government that's angry with the CIA, specifically the Senate. They were looking at reports about CIA torture, rendition, and they got spied on by the CIA. Staffers were tapped into. Now, they took then-Director Brennan before the Senate committee, and he said to them, he said, as far as the allegations, you know, CIA hacking into, you know, Senate computers, nothing could be further from the truth. I mean, we wouldn't do that. I mean, it's just beyond the, you know, the scope and reason in terms of what we would do, he said. Well, you know what? He came back today and he said, actually, we were doing that. And he actually apologized, which is good. He apologized to the Senate for essentially doing a J. Edgar Hoover on him. This is something that the intelligence community has been notorious for the longest amount of time. But it's interesting that he did finally admit it in this war going back and forth between Senate leaders. What he did not apologize for was the rendition, the detention, and the torture and assassination, which was the subject of the investigation. Now, they're going to lay hard on that. And if you remember, CIA Director John Brennan was one of Obama's point men on the drone assassinations. It's one of the reasons he was picked as CIA chief. Now, it's not just the CIA that's going to be coming after your information, of course. You can be hacked by any number of individuals, and those hackers can control your phone, according to Wired Magazine, using a tool that's already built into it. Now, this is very similar to what we saw with Intel. Remember, we did these reports a while back that showed that Intel had put software in that would let them do diagnostics remotely on your laptop. I don't know why that would be so important for you. I mean, typically, if you have a problem with your computer, we usually take it to the shop. But yes, they're going to be able to remotely tap in and do diagnostics. They've put that sort of thing into iPhones and other smartphones, and that makes it very easy for hackers, especially the intelligence services, to hack in. They say a lot of concern about the NSA's seemingly omnipresent surveillance over the last year has focused on the agency's efforts to install backdoors and software and hardware. But those efforts are greatly aided, however, if the agency can piggyback on embedded software that's already there. Do you think they know about that software? I think they do. If you remember, it wasn't that long ago, it was just the beginning of this year, that there were some Snowden documents that showed them laughing about the fact and the irony that even though it was Steve Jobs, an Apple computer that had the iconic 1984 commercial, they said, who would have thought in 1984 that this, and they show Steve Jobs holding up an iPhone, would be Big Brother, and they show people lined up like zombies to buy the iPhone. Of course, they know that, and there's been numerous reports about backdoors that have been put in knowingly by the manufacturers of these smartphones and by the carriers. In this particular case, it's under the guise of saying that they can do remote diagnostics and corrections. Now, if you also remember, there's been a lot of talk about one of the companies, Palantir. They were tied in the Snowden documents to the Prism leaks. They did have a program called Prism. And by their very name, Palantir, and the fact that they were started by a CIA venture capital company, InQtel, and the fact that they're essentially looking through the internet to look inside of you and do data mining, determine what you're up to, what you're thinking about, what you're doing. The Wall Street Journal points out that Palantir has now acquired social analytics specialist PopTip. It's a two-year-old company that analyzes data from Twitter. They say the acquisition by Palantir, which specializes in large-scale data mining for the FBI, the CIA, and Wall Street firms, reflects the growing value of Twitter's data as an indicator of social trends. Now, of course, we had a report not too long ago on Infowars.com from Paul Joseph Watson pointing out that they had actually used Facebook as an experiment on people to try to manipulate their moods, to try to make people depressed or to make them happy. It's not just about watching you to sell you products. And of course, that's the way the Wall Street Journal portrays this. If you look at this picture, and right there in the article, they got a picture of Hayden Panettiere, and they said that talk about her hairdo at the Golden Globes helped to guide a L'Oreal promo. And actually what they did was they monitored everybody's conversation about that, and if people were talking about her hairdo and the hairdos of the other people that were there, then they sent them a commercial. You see, it's also about corporate espionage, and that's one of the reasons why the Germans are so upset about the NSA. They know that it's not simply about politics. It's also about trading corporate secrets. But they are going to be looking and analyzing your Twitter feeds. They want to understand not only what you as an individual are doing, but they want to understand what we as a society are doing so they can not only make more money, but that they can control us. And part of that control may be crashing, pumping and crashing the economy. There's so many reasons why you should be concerned about the surveillance state. But going on to this, now we see that an article out of the EU, Google says that it has a right to notify publishers of forgotten requests. Now, a lot of controversy was created when the EU came up with its right to be forgotten law. Now, that basically goes right after Google's business model. And so Google is fighting back. The search giant has gone public to defend its practice of telling websites when some of their content has been removed from Google searches, arguing that such flagging is essential to maintaining a fair balance. Now, this goes back to a May ruling from the EU that gives individuals a right to request the removal of information about them from search results. But it also requires that search engines balance those requests against a public interest. Now, the regulators are upset about this, and yet Google says that there is no legal basis under the EU privacy law to stop them from notifying people because sharing the link that has been removed does not include any personal data. Now, this is an interesting case because although we want to have privacy, this allows Google to essentially memory hole information about any individual that they want to hide. For example, if Henry Kissinger were to do something that he doesn't want us to find out about, they could basically remove all the search engine results from that. So it cuts both ways. Basically, we should be able to see what is out there and not have that censored, I believe. And yet, the real problem, of course, is when they analyze our data, as we see with this case with Palantir, with the CIA, when they mine that data, restrictions need to be put on our government. Perhaps the best thing we could do is, as Ron Paul suggested, get rid of the CIA. We've tried to reform them with the church committee hearings. That doesn't work. The CIA needs to be dismantled and spread to the corners of the earth, as JFK is reported to have said. Now, stay with us right after the break. The Border Patrol is actually on top of the charts in Central America, but it's actually a propaganda song. We're going to analyze the propaganda in it and look at some propaganda that maybe isn't quite so obvious. Stay with us. We'll be right back after the break.
City of Austin tap water versus filtered City of Austin tap water.
I can, like, taste dirt in it.
God knows what's in this.
This has an aftertaste. Tastes like Austin water?
Yeah, it does. Ugh.
These people just sampled City of Austin tap water straight from the faucet. Next, we had them try a sample of tap water filtered through the ProPure G2.0 filtration system.
High quality H2O.
That one is better.
Tastes like nothing.
Yep, I know what good water tastes like. It's good water.
Most tap water contains added substances like fluoride, chlorine, Monsanto's deadly pesticide, glyphosate, and many others. Studies prove that these substances are linked to an assortment of major health issues, including tooth decay, lowered IQ, and even cancer.
It tastes like you're drinking out of the lake when you're drinking tap water.
Yeah, it has that processed flavor to it.
The ProPure G2.0 filtration system removes these deadly substances and many more, leaving only fresh-tasting, deliciously clean water.
Okay, this is very tasty.
It's good water.
Refreshing.
It's good.
Go to InfoWarsStore.com today. Use promo code WATER and save 10% off your ProPure purchase. Again, that's InfoWarsStore.com or call 1-888-253-3139.